19 continues to count down until the first launch window for Artemis 1.
And that first launch window, early Monday morning. And the rocket has been on the launch pad. It's waiting, ready to go. News 19's Emily Forrester joins us now in the studio with details.
Yeah, NASA hopes to launch its most powerful rocket in history sometime over the next 10 days, and their first chance to do so will be Monday morning. The mission itself is a test for any future missions. So instead of astronauts on board, mannequins will fly out to orbit the moon. And this test run is not cheap. The 42-day mission coming in with a $4 billion price tag. Future missions won't take nearly as long, though. Instead, NASA is nearly doubling the flight time of future astronaut missions. The administration says the unmanned mission allows them to push the space launch system to the absolute limit to ensure a safe return to the moon over 50 years in the making. NASA Administrator Bill Nelson says when we do return, it will also make history as the longest lunar visit.
The first landing to 2025 is going to be 6.5 days. Eventually, we're going to have a habitable rover. They're going to get in without their spacesuits and roam around the surface.
Now, because this is a test run, the mission may be cut short if something fails. But if everything goes according to plan, the Orion capsule will safely splash down in the Pacific with all its mannequin crew in one piece.
Now, Emily, once the rocket lifts off, how long is it going to take the Orion capsule to get to the moon?
Yeah, to reach the moon's orbit, the Orion will have to cover nearly 240,000 miles. So that's going to take about a week. Once it does reach the moon, the capsule will enter a distant orbit, putting the Orion farther from Earth than any Apollo mission. That also means when they splash down, they will be coming back to Earth much faster. NASA tells us the increased re-entry speed will give them an idea of how the Orion can handle the hotter returns by future Mars crews. Now, if the weather is bad Monday morning or they have to scrub the launch for any other reasons, NASA will get to try again next Friday and, if needed, Monday, September 5th. And if they can't get the rocket off the launch pad by then, the rocket will be wheeled back and they wouldn't be allowed to try to launch again until sometime later this year.